In this video, I'm going to show you some of the advanced techniques that you can do with webcams. Did you realize, for example, that you can move the webcam around on the screen, or that you can resize the webcam? You can even put a frame around the webcam, and you can even use the webcam full screen. I'm going to show you five great techniques that you can use to really work with the webcam and make more use of it to make your videos as visually compelling as possible. Really hope you like the videos, and always, if you do, please like it, please share it with other teachers and trainers, please join me on my YouTube channel, and of course comment and tell me which of the techniques you like the best. Let's get started. So normally when you record with the webcam, you've got your kind of whatever you're talking about in the background, and then you've got the webcam here as well on the screen. And the first thing to notice is that you've actually got control over both of those things. So if I click on the webcam on its own, I can just resize it immediately. So now if I played that video, the webcam would be much bigger. So that's the first thing to keep in mind. You have actually got control, because it records on two separate channels. If you're recording both the screen of your computer but you've got the webcam on, you're going to have two channels, and you can just click on that webcam channel and then you can resize it. So that's the first thing to remember. Now, a good little tip is when you're doing that is turn off the other channel. You can lock the other channel just so that you can't actually do anything with that channel. So therefore you can't edit this accidentally. And that way you can just simply work and resize and move wherever you want the webcam actually to be on the screen. Now, whenever I do my training, the next little trick, when I actually show people, they think, oh, of course, that's so obvious. So really important little trick. Let's say you want to move the webcam. So you want to start with the webcam here, and it's probably a bit big. So what we can do is we can crop it a little bit. I'm going to get rid of the green screen. We'll be coming back and looking at the green screen later on in this video anyway. But let's say we're going to move the green screen, and I didn't mean to do that, sorry. I'm going to move the green screen, or move the webcam, and have it on this side of the screen. So we're going to play the video a bit. So the first technology that we're going to look at is Google Earth. Google Earth is free. And at this point here, I'm going to cut the video. Remember, this part's not going to be edited because I've got it locked completely. So I'm going to cut the video, but it's only going to cut the webcam part. And from this point onwards, I'm going to shift the webcam to here. So it's going to work as if that's two separate videos. So we've got one with the video on the left now. And at that point, free, and it comes with the Google, and the video will shift. Just to do that again, let's just move it a little bit further. Again, select the video, cut it at that point, and at that point, I'm going to move the video up to here. Okay, so now with the video, we'll be in three places. First of all, we start on the left, then we jump to the right, and then at this point, find it in your app. We jump to the top. So that's how you can make the video move around. Now, when you move that video around, you can also resize. So we've got it, for example, here quite big. And what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to resize the video, because it's only going to resize that segment. It's not going to do this because it's going to count this as three separate segments of video now. I'm going to resize that video. So what we're going to actually have now is your products. You can find it in your apps, that the webcam moves up to here, but it's a different size as well. So that's the trick, really, to simply cut and splice and then move the webcam in the different segments of the video. Now, sometimes in the video, you might actually want the webcam to be full screen. And you can do that as well. In fact, really, if you just click and pull the webcam open onto the screen, you can make it as big as you possibly can. And we could do it like that. Okay, so what we've got now is that at this point, the webcam is fairly small and it's on the right-hand side. Obviously, at this point, the webcam is fairly small and it's on the left. But now, when we come into that third point, and let's just play that video and find it in your apps. Now, I didn't even bother to delete the other track. I could actually delete that at this point as well, because there's really no point in having the other track, as you're obviously not going to see what's behind there. But really, in reality, if the webcam covers it, you might as well leave the track there, because you can then obviously bring it back onto the screen immediately it disappears. The track will come back on again if we just click to unlock that. And obviously the track ends anyway, but if, for example, just to show you what I mean, if I only had the full screen at that point, then when the video finishes, then the track obviously will appear in the behind it. Now I'm just going to show you another technique when we can use the webcam full screen. And for this one, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to delete the other channel completely. So we've just got the webcam on the screen and nothing else. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to enlarge that webcam. And obviously the quality of the webcam when you enlarge it is going to depend on the webcam that you're using. I tend to use a really high quality webcam to get the best quality image. Therefore, when I expand it in size, it doesn't look too bad. But if you come down again to your visual effects, you do have the option to drop a device onto a device frame. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to just drag this one on, and you can see now that the webcam is sitting inside a computer image, and we've got a few devices that we can choose. For example, we can change that for an iPhone. Okay, that's probably not that good. Or we can change it, for example, for a desktop, or in fact a MacBook as well. Okay, so that's another technique that you might be interested in using. Just a super quick break from the video. If you like what you're seeing and you want more videos about using Camtasia, then please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com and click on the section that's called screen capture, and you'll see that there's a whole range of videos here about using Camtasia. Now, I'm also a Camtasia recommended trainer, and I run courses in working with Camtasia. And if you're interested in joining one of those courses, then add your name to the waiting list below in the description. And the next time I run a course, I'll send you the information. The course is normally a webinar of an hour and a half with me, where I go through the basics, plus access to a complete course in using Camtasia. And the price is normally 60 euros. So if you're interested, please add your name in the waiting list below. Let's get back to the video. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete all of that off the screen just to make this much easier, and just drag on the whole video again. Start right from the beginning, and I'm just going to make that a little bit bigger. So let me just again see, I've made a mistake there. I've kind of forgot to make sure that I'm only working with this channel. So lock this channel again. It's always the easiest thing to do. And that way you can only be working with the one channel. This channel's locked. So I'm going to grab the webcam, make it a little bit bigger. And what I want to point out to you, and this is a technique I use again, I'm going to first of all crop the image, so get rid of a lot of the green area around the outside, okay? And this is quite a nice technique, and it is something I do a lot. I'm going to position the webcam about there, and then I'm going to come down onto my visual effects, and I'm going to drop border around that image. And what I'm going to do, make sure that you click it back onto this one, okay? It's kind of where you can just resize. That's the crop button, this is the resize. I'm gonna shift that out to be as thick as possible, so I want a nice white border. And what I often try to do is pull a color out from the image itself, so I can click here, and let's say, for example, I wanna use that blue color there. So just click on it, and that becomes the border. And that means I can kind of match the border with something else in the image. And that's a technique I use a lot. I really like the idea of having the border. Now, this final technique is one that people always ask me about, and that is, how do I do this effect where I'm on the screen? And again, the best way to do this is to lock this back screen for now. I'm on the screen, but the background is clear as well. So in other words, there's no green. It's just completely clear, and you can see the presentation behind me. Well, the technique I'm using here, first of all, you might notice that I've recorded myself with a green screen. And you'll also notice that I'm kind of wearing red, which contrasts really well. So there's no green in my image. And that's important, because what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go down to visual effects, and then I'm going to say remove a color. And then it's going to say, well, what color do you want to remove? And I'm going to say, I want to remove green. And I'm going to get about the shade as well as I can. So I'm going to choose about here. And you can see now that it's removed a lot of the color, and it's not quite worked, and there's some green left. So what I can do is I can increase the tolerance. So I might put it up to about 15%, and that will tell me now whether it's all gone. Or what I can do is just do it again. Maybe I chose the wrong shade of green. You've got to get the right balance to do this well. So I'm going to just do another example. I'm going to drop that on again, and I'm going to click here, and let's just try a slightly lighter choice. See if that works better. And that does seem to work better, actually. So let me increase the tolerance now, and I should be able to get rid of everything. So now what I've got is me, but all the green is missing from my image. And what I can do now is kind of move myself onto the screen wherever I want to be. And then again, what I'll often do here is, again, crop the image, just since I don't need all that space around the outside. So the technique is to go to visual effects and remove color. Now the trick to doing this is to make sure that the green screen that's sitting behind you is very well lit effect. And in fact, this one here I didn't do very well because I forgot to turn on one of my lights, and that's the reason why I had to increase the tolerance to 22%. You really don't want to increase the tolerance if you can avoid it. If you've used the correct lighting and it's nice and bright and you've contrasted the colors that you're wearing with the green screen, you really should have no problem. Okay, so really hoped you liked that video. Remember, if you come over to teachertrainingvideos.com, click on screen capture. There's a nice collection of videos here about Camtasia. Remember also, if you're interested in doing my course, then add your name to the waiting list. There's no obligation. I'll simply send you the information the next time the course runs. It includes a webinar with me, which I record, plus access to a complete course in working with Camtasia. The other thing that you can do is follow me on my channel by signing up to the newsletter, and that way you get updated with all the blogs, the webinars, the online courses, and the latest videos. Of course, you can follow me on my YouTube channel, and I think we're up to around 65,000 subscribers now. And finally, if you did want me to do some training with your organization, obviously Camtasia might be one of the technologies, then you can contact me from the website. And on the screen now, I'm going to leave some other videos about Camtasia that you might find interesting.